Okay, so it's loading. I'm not sure we can see your screen till now.
Just give me a moment. It is visible now?
Yeah, now we can see your screen.
Fantastic. So I'm hopefully everyone is joined now. I'm going to like share with today's topic now.
Let's start with it.
Yeah. So I'm started like a recording for this particular session so that everybody who is going to like miss this a video or session, they can just refer back to our YouTube channel also. This fine, Parsu?
Yeah, we have also did the same. So
fantastic.
We'll try to spread the both of the links to everyone fantastic. Who has missed it.
Fantastic. So let me move very quickly about my next slide deck. About myself, I am Amul Barnwal. I am currently working with one of the technology company Techmetrics in Noida based. And they are a partner of Salesforce since like 11 years now. These are all my social profile link for Twitter and LinkedIn. I'm moving to my next slide deck, where as I like already talked about, Partha has talked about, like I have already my one of the YouTube channel that I have been showcasing free of cost to excel your knowledge on a Salesforce CPQ platform. I'm hopefully like I'm audible to everyone. If it is not like audible to everyone, just let us know so that I can speak loudly. I'm moving to my next slide deck, where I will discuss about the agenda item today. We'll discuss about like this one is for our basic CPQ one. So I will cover in next 45 minutes, I will cover what is CPQ, how to install the Salesforce CPQ as a AppExchange packages, and what all basic setup do you need before you start with the Salesforce CPQ stuff. Then in the CPQ, we'll also talk about the standalone product and the bundle product, what exactly the meaning, how it has been different, what exactly the difference between these two product type called standalone and bundle product. Now we'll also discuss about how you can, we'll also discuss about how to start creating the bundle in the system. We'll give you the demo one by one to start with these features, to create the options, what is actually the definition of option constraint. We'll also discuss much about the while defining those bundles or product, how this pricing method is going to like help you. And last but not the least, we'll also discuss about the code template and code PDF document, how you can generate and present to the customer. Moving to my next slide deck, what is actually the CPQ? The CPQ stands for Configure, Price, and Quote. What is actually the meaning of C? C is basically you are going to configure your bundle, you are going to configure your individual product, you are going to configure your line editor page, you are going to configure your layouts, you are going to configure your product rule, and etc. These are all comes under your configuration areas. The more I will start giving you the demo session, you guys will be able to understand the whole console meaning of this CPQ. CPQ is the standard terminology that you can say. Now in India, now in like all over the globe, you can say somewhere around like 15 product comes under the CPQ. Some of them are supporting to the AI now, some of them supporting to our augmented reality based also, so that any user who is going to quote to the customer, they can visualize those configuration on the screen. Moving to the next slide deck, what is actually the meaning of P? P stands for pricing. Pricing has the different terminology in the CPQ model. Price part, if you discuss about, we'll discuss also detail what is actually the meaning of list price, block price, cost price, or percent of total pricing. Salesforce does provide this price methodology, as well as how to configure your discounting schedule, how to configure your price rule and price lookup actually. So these are all term to define this product to derive a certain price from the system. It's called this is what called P stand for our pricing strategy. Now coming to the Q is for your quotation. The more after like creating a product and pricing is being derived from the system, you generally used to generate your quote. After generating a quote PDF document, you would like to present to the customer. Sometime you generally used to get the signed a document from the customer. In that scenario, CPQ also provide your Adobe Shine as well as it also provides your DocuSign. So you can install those plugins in the CPQ platform whenever any customers or company would like to send a quotation to the customer and would like to send a signed on those document. These plugins also supported on this Salesforce CPQ App Access packages. We'll also like give you the demo how to configure this product bundle pricing as well as like quote PDF document and how you can generate and present to the customer one by one. I'm moving to my next slide deck. To start with the installation of the Salesforce CPQ, if you guys are new to the Salesforce CPQ platform, there is a Salesforce CPQ playground is available. I am going to share this PPT to you people all. I will share to Partha, who is our coordinator team for today's session. I will pass on to my team member. They will going to share on social media as well as my YouTube channel will be available. Now, these are all two basic links actually. One is like if you wanted to start with your playground. What exactly the playground meaning that? Playground will create a developer org for you that will be available for 3 months of period of time. Within 90 days, you can configure your product, configure your pricing, configure your bundle. Whatever you wanted to configure related to the CPQ, you can just use those. As well as the Salesforce CPQ, if you are using the playground installation link, what it does, it will provide you the default code template, default like the product and pricing get created automatically by this playground engine. If you go by like installation into your developer or in any one of your production or in your sandboxes, then what you guys can install or use this Steelbrick link. Let me share how this link is visible. Partha, I am audible, right? Partha, are you there?
Hi, you are audible.
Okay, fine. Okay, so now if you start clicking on this steelbrick2.force.com/apex/install-premium, this Salesforce CPQ has like a three license type. One is called Salesforce CPQ. Another one is called Salesforce CPQ Plus, and third one is called Salesforce CPQ Plus Billing actually. Now the Salesforce CPQ Plus has your Salesforce CPQ licenses as well as Plus means the advanced approval. Advanced approval where you need like some kind of like a smart approval. This Salesforce CPQ also does provide your approval engine or approval applications where you can install this Salesforce advanced approval package, and that will help to admin user to configure these in your sandboxes or production environment accordingly. So these are the link where you can go and install this in your org. But after like installation, what all steps that are needed if you are installing these packages? If you wanted to go by your trial org or playground org, this is the link developer.salesforce.com/promotion/org/CPQ-trials. You have to fill this first name, last name and email addresses. These are all details you will have to fill and just submit for a sign up on. So what you will get one activation email on your email ID that you have submitted for. So in your trial org, you will receive this such kind of like an email, activation email, and you will have to just verify this activation. After activation, you will end up into the install link, install packages section. Let me show you after installation how it will look like. Can everybody go on mute? Thanks. Okay. If you go to the install packages, what it happen, you can see the Salesforce CPQ packages, it is get installed on your our platform. So you can see the three links. One is called uninstall, configure, and manage licenses. You'll have to just click on a configure button. What it does after installation, there is some basic setup that you have to initiate actually before starting with the Salesforce CPQ product or permissions that you wanted to define. So in your configuration screen of the Salesforce CPQ, these are all a document section, different tab for different purpose. I will go and dig into the more part, what all tab is required, why it is been required, and how it is been configured actually. So let me navigate to my slide deck, original slide deck. Moving to my next slide deck, after installation, the first step, what you have to do, you'll have to click on this request authorization. So what it does, there is some API enablement is required, and the Salesforce CPQ, they generally used to ask to authorize this application on your sandboxes or on your environment. That is why this request authorization is very much required after installation. This is the first step, navigating to my next slide deck. After installation, there is a one execute script link is available. This execute script that you have to click after installation. And this one is basically for your JavaScript plugin that are being configured in the Salesforce CPQ actually. These plugins comes in their memories to calculate their pricing or overriding the quantity easily. That is why this execute script helps CPQ engine to process their products and pricing strategy. Now I'm navigating to my next slide deck, which I have, I told about the Salesforce CPQ after installation, what it does, Salesforce CPQ uses your standard object and custom object. After installation, if you go about and see what all standard object that they generally used to use, they are using the account, opportunities, product to object, assets, and contract. These are the all standard object they generally used to use. Now, if you talk about like a custom object, quote line item, product option, block pricing, additional discounting document model, and the price rule, there are n number of custom object are being used by this Salesforce CPQ program. The moment you installed, these are all detail. You can see what all custom object are built, what all like standard object they have been using. This article will help you to visualize this data model accordingly. And whomsoever is going to support on the Salesforce CPQ as a admin or as a like a techno-functional role, they must to be aware about these object and data model, how these Salesforce CPQ packages are being used. Okay. I'm moving to my next slide deck. Like my third step is to layout configuration. Actually, the Salesforce CPQ, what it does, as I told you, they are using the standard object called product, count, opportunities, assets, and contract. That is why they are using the standard product object. So in this scenario, you'll have to enable those fields and related object on the layout in order to configure the CPQ model actually. So if you see this page, I have my product, I'm on standard product definition page. In this definition page, you can see the my product code, my product family. These are all standard field actually. Now, if you talk about the Salesforce CPQ configuration section, you can see the configuration type, you can see the configuration event, you can see the configured code pattern. These are all fields are related to our CPQ. And if you see about this product related list called features, option constraint, configuration attribute, configuration rule, block prices or price dimension, price book, and etc. Right? These are all related list or has to be available on your CPQ page layout actually. So before you start with this CPQ page, CPQ like definition as an admin, let's suppose you are going to work, So you will have to change this layout so that you have to be aware about what all functionality are being provided by our Salesforce APQ platform. So let me give you the idea how to update your CPQ page layout. These are all steps. If you go to click on your setup, go to the object manager, open these objects, account, opportunities, and product. Go to the page layout section, define your own CPQ page layout and all CPQ related field and sections, enable them on the layout and assign to you as a admin or assign to the end user if you wanted to enable for them. Now, Salesforce CPQ after installation, they also provide the standard CPQ layouts also. If you wanted to use the standard CPQ layout, go and assign for yourself. If you are working as an admin, you can go and assign for yourself so that no need to go and change your existing layout. Existing layout may be assigned to someone else for your end purpose, right? So do not need to hamper those layouts. So before you start with any kind of like a changes, you have to assign yourself as an admin and just check those functionality and then move forward. Let me navigate to the demo part in the Salesforce APQ. After like installation, you will see here one request authorization. In additional setting, you will see this execute script. After clicking on execute script, after installation, you will have to click on this execute script. What it does, it will show you the latest status called queued. Keep refreshing, it will show you like completed now. So after completion, this Salesforce APQ is now ready for use. These are all basic configuration we'll discuss in detail in the later session. Now, let me navigate to my object manager. I talked about like object manager is my third step or fourth step. They have to opt. Now, I'm going to my account object as Salesforce APQ uses my account object also. So this page layout, if you talk about CPQ account layout, this is the standard layout provided by the Salesforce APQ. If you open this layout, let me open this layout first. If you open this layout, you see the one section called renewal quotum information. It has all contract quotum model. It has renewal model. So these are all field and sections are related to Salesforce APQ. I'm not going to discuss about this field information. What is actually the purpose of this? Definitely down the line once we move further for basic to the advanced one, we'll discuss in detail. Now, if you go a little down, you will see the contract objects. So these are all contract related lists. You can see the contracted price. Contracted price are the object are related to the Salesforce CPQ AppExchange package. Assets are standard package, standard object. Subscription are basically your Salesforce CPQ provides this object. Order is a standard object. So these are all related list has to be appear before you start with your account and customer creation part. Now moving to the another object, which is very much important for our admin. If I go back to the product object now. So similarly, if you go to the product object and the page layout, in the page layout section, as I told you, the Salesforce CPQ automatically install this package and creates this page layout. Let's open this CPQ product layout, how it will look like. These are all field. If you see the Salesforce CPQ configuration, pricing sections, subscription section, upgrade section, renewal sections. If you see about the related object called block price, cost price, price dimension, features, options, option constraint, product section, configuration rule, configuration attribute, these are all related object are totally related to the Salesforce CPQ program. We'll discuss one by one, step by step. Okay, after like enabling these fields and related object on the product layout, on your account layout, on your contract layout, on your opportunity layout, my next step to assign this layout to the admin who is going to be like work as a CPQ admin actually. So you'll have to do the assignment of these layouts. So what I will do, I will get them assigned for myself on my system admin. So I'm using this training product layout. Why this training product layout? This training product layout, because I have initiated my CPQ trial org. I haven't initiated in my developer already. Okay. So this Salesforce CPQ training layout will only be applicable and available the moment you are using your trial links, the playground links that I talked about. Okay. Just to give you a more update, let me go back to my slide deck. Okay. I have given you the two process where you start with your installation. One installation link, the standard steel brick. Another one is called your playground link. In the playground link, you will see the training layout actually. So you'll have to use the training layout. It will be by default, will be applicable for the admin. So no need to change about these layouts and settings. But if you are installing the AppExchange application on your production or sandboxes or even your developer org, these are all initial steps are very much required. Now moving to my next slide deck, what I have left else. Okay. In my this slide deck, I'm going to discuss about what is actually the meaning of standalone product, what is actually the meaning of bundle product. As you see, I'm on currently on standalone product. Standalone product are basically all finished good product or standalone product. Does not require any kind of like a modification and configuration, any changes actually before you sell to the customer. So the moment it is been produced, you'll have to sell it. You'll have to just give the MRP price and that's it. Now, if you talk about the bundle product comes with the packages actually. It's all combined of three or four component in it actually. So one is, I'm giving one of the example here. I have a camera. In the camera, I have also like one package product called camera case. Then we have a memory card. And then we have a warranty. So these all four component comes under one bundle called camera bundle. So this camera bundle is totally contains these four product altogether. Okay, in order to configure this bundle, I will give you the demo. Before I start with demo, I would like to give you the setup area, how you can create those bundle within the system. You'll have to create all the product. As I'm pretty much sure, you guys are aware about how to start with the product. You will have to start creating the product, go to the product tab, click on the new button, provide your product code, product name, market active, and click on save button. After defining the product, you'll have to define the price book also. In that price book, let's suppose you are using USD price book, you are using the GBP pound price book or Euro price book, you'll have to keep adding those price book accordingly on your price book setup. After defining this product, what you have to do, you'll have to create a bundle product actually. Okay, the bundle product are nothing but it's a bundle product is also a product, and that product has a different option in it actually. So I will give you the demo. You will be able to understand more about this bundle product and options. In that bundle, you will have to define the features. Under the feature, you will have to define the options actually. So these are all steps that you have to follow in order to create the bundle product. So I will take this example. It's a demo time now. So I am using this Canon camera bundle. In this Canon camera bundle, I have Canon ZV-20M 20 megapixel camera, which price is $700. Another one is our case. Camera case, we have a $70, and the memory card, which is 128 GB of $30 of rupees, and 1 year warranty, which comes a free of cost in that bundle actually. Now, how to configure this bundle in the Salesforce APQ? Let's move up to our Salesforce browser. Okay, I'm on product. Let me click on new. So my first setup is I'll have to create this I'll have to create this product code and product name. So let me give my product name, market active. Then you have a product code. You have to define the product family called hardware. Okay, so now coming to the another part called configuration type. We will discuss in detail what is actually the meaning of configuration type. We have configuration type and configuration event. We'll discuss in detail. Let's creating these values as it is required and always. I'm creating this bundle product. The price method is always list price, your MRP price, and keep everything is as it is and click on save button. Now, after defining this product, what I have to do, I will have to define the price. Until unless price is not there in the price book, the product will not be visible. I will have to go to the price book, add standard price book. What is my price book? My price book is $700. I would like to give 700 here. Click on save. Okay. Now you see, I have created this 20 megapixel digicam. There is also a button called clone with related. This is also a Salesforce APQ button. What it does, it will create, it will clone your product record as well as your child record automatically. Just I am hitting this button, clone with related. Click on clone button. Let me copy. I'm going to create another product name called camera cache. Let me change quickly the name of my product. This is my product code. Okay. Again, this is configuration is not required because it's a item that is going to be like club in the my bundle product. Keep price as a list price here. Just click on save. Now in this, you'll have to just go back to our price book and change the price. This is $70. Okay, I have created my camera cache, second product. I'm going to create a third product. My third product is basically memory card. Let me create the memory card. This is get cloned. After cloning, I have to change the product name. Let me change the product name. Product code, product name. Memory card 128 GB. This is the list price. List price is basically your MRP price, your standard price book. Whatever you are going to define in your price book, the same price will be appear on your code. This 128 GB memory card price is basically $30. Click on save. After defining this memory card, my next last item is Canon 1 year warranty. With related, click on clone button. I have Canon warranty 1 year product. It's called support. Okay. Again, this is the list price, but this list price will be a $0.
कहाँ?
Sorry guys, can you go on mute? Okay. Now what I did so far, I have created all my four product, Canon 20 megapixel, Canon ZV camera case and memory card and Canon warranty. What I have to do, I'll have to mark this product as a bundle product actually in my system, right? So that if I'm picking up this Canon camera, I will by default, this Canon camera case, memory card and 1 year warranty will be automatically should be included. So what I have to do in order to define this product as a bundle, I will have to pick up this bundle, this product. Let me go and select this bundle, this product, Canon DigiCam. And under this DigiCam, you will see the options and features. Okay. What do you have to do? I'm going to define one feature. Feature is basically your grouping of your product, or you are going to categorize your display under this machine or bundle. So the feature is basically a logical grouping of your product. So let's suppose in your package or in your bundle, you have your hardware, you have your software, you have your installation, you have training, you have accessories product, right? You have cost and freight services also. So this cost and freight, the software, the hardware, accessories, these are all what you call the logical category of the product. So feature is basically your logical category. So what I'm trying to do, I have my product called main machine, right? A main hardware machine, right? So I am typing all main product. In this main product, I will see my one of the product name called camera, main camera, main machine, right? I can select only one options or minimum and maximum option. What it does from these features or from this category, how many product I can choose? So I can choose minimum one and maximum one. What is that meaning? I can select only a maximum of one product from this category. So let me select this one and click on save. So I'm creating three different feature or call logical grouping. One is called main product. Another one is called case. Number is basically your sequencing, how you wanted to display your category. Category one, first main machine, then hardware, then software, then accessories. So 10 and 20, why I'm giving 10 and 20? In order to, let's suppose down the line, you like to add more, one more in between, you can give the any number actually. So you can give two or three or whatever. I'm putting a 10, 20, 30, 40 likewise. So I have main product, which is camera product. I have a case, another category. Then I have a third category called memory. This is my third display called 30. Minimum one and maximum one I'm putting here. And click on save. I'm going to create another feature called warranty and support. Minimum one, maximum one, and this is called 40 sequence. So this is number is basically your sequence, how you wanted to display. So I have 10, 20, 30, and 40. These are all my features available in this bundle. So whenever any person will pick this bundle, they will see the main product called Canon camera. Then they will see the cases, they will see the memories, they will see the warranty actually. Okay. Let me go back to the, after creating the feature, now my next step is to add the options in it. So options are basically a component in that product. Let me add. So my next section will be in order to add, let's suppose I would like to, this is the, under this camera, I have what options? I have three more options called case, memory card, and warranty. Let me add case, display called 10, under feature call, I would like to display under category called case. So let's suppose you have three cases, four cases of different type. You'll have to keep adding under these options actually. So product options are basically what all component available in these bundle before you configure and sell to the customer or quote to the customer. Okay, I would like to go with the by default selected and required. The selected meaning that whenever any sales rep is going to configure this bundle for the quotation, this will be selected by default. And required meaning that I cannot like remove these configurations. I must have to buy, I must have to sell to the quotations. Okay. So this is the one option that I have added, means this Canon product have now one options called camera case. My second option will be memory card. Let me create another options. Memory card. 128 GB. This is the sequence number called 20. Selected, required. I cannot change. Again, one and feature called memory. Click on save. And similarly, you will have to add your warranty product. This is the last product. So let me go back and add my last product called warranty. Canon warranty 1 year. Selected, required, quantity one, feature called warranty. Okay, click on save. Okay, so this way you can define your bundle. Means I have what I did, I have defined my quota. I have defined each product with mark as active and mark, I have created these price books also. After defining this product and price book, my next step to create the features and add these options in the bundle, in this particular bundle. So this product will have three additional component in it. These three component are basically your camera case, your memory card, and the warranty. Okay. Now it's time to create the quotation. So let's see how any end user can go and create the quote to the customer. Let me give you the demo here very quickly. We go and launch my Salesforce CPQ application. Okay. I'm going to open one of the account name called Emergent Transport. What I will do, I will first create one opportunity called Canon camera 20 megapixel deal. I would like to give the quotation, then click on save. So these are all steps that I have to follow. I'll have to create first opportunity from the existing customer or new customer. Then after creating an opportunity, what I have to do next? I will have to create a new quote. This is the lightning action button called new quote. Now, if you see on opportunity, you can see the different Salesforce CPQ sections. This is again, the Salesforce CPQ provides a default layouts called Salesforce CPQ layout for opportunity. These are all fields are related to the Salesforce CPQ model. And then application. This is the quote is basically your custom object. Custom object are being used by our Salesforce CPQ. Click on quote. Let's start creating this prime. What is actually the meaning of primary here? The primary meaning here is if you are adding any quote line item, what it does after creating those quote and adding the product, if you mark that quote as a primary, what it does, Salesforce CPQ will automatically sync the quote line item to the opportunity line item by default. I'm skipping this field. These fields are not really required because I am selling the standalone product. I'm not selling any kind of like a subscription product as of now. Click on save button. With the default a data information, I have created my code. I'm going to open my code. This is the Salesforce CPQ code where you see the cart icon. This cart icon is basically your Salesforce CPQ code. And this Salesforce CPQ code has code line groups, code document, additional documents, orders, and another standard of tab or object called related item called notes and attachment. These are all buttons are related to our Salesforce CPQ for the code, call edit line, review document, generate document, create order, and there are a bunch of more called modify code terms, include clone with related, and these are all standard one. Some of them are standard one. This import line are also a part of our Salesforce CPQ. If you wanted to create a code from your Excel sheet, there is a predefined template. You'll have to define first the template. So admin will define the template and they can upload this code line item from Excel sheet and create a code within the system. Okay. Now I'm moving to the button name called edit line. Edit line will navigate to my code edit line editor page. The moment you hit this edit line page, Salesforce CPQ will navigate to my code line editor page. Here you will have an option to choose your price book. If you are using the multiple price book, you'll have the and number of price book will be available based on the definition that you have defined in your system. If you are using your USD price book or Euro price book or GBP price book, you will see the those price book accordingly. I have only one price book called standard price book. I'm selecting the one. I can make this default also. I will let you know later on. Let me click on the add product section. So the moment you hit this add product button, Salesforce CPQ will land up onto the search layout, where you can see the product code, product name, product family, and these are the product description and list price. So these are all product that you have configured in your system. These are all get displaced. If that product is active and has the price book defined, then it will be available here. So I have defined one product name called Canon. Let me click on a Canon. This one is called Canon 20 megapixel camera. It's a hardware. I am going to select this hardware. Okay, what it does, because this particular product called Canon 20 megapixel digital camera has these features called cases, memories, and warranty. Let me open side by side so that you have a better understanding here. I have these three options available called case, memories, and warranty. So similarly, if you go to this Canon digital camera configurator screen, this is called configurator screen, you can see the case. Under this case, you will have one option product which is required, right? So you cannot alter this definitions of the bundle that you have created, but it is again a provision in the Salesforce CPQ side where you wanted to make them provision to choose or do not choose, you can make them provision accordingly in the definition. Now, after defining this bundle, you'll have to click on save button. So let's suppose you have a 32 GB like a product here. Let me navigate and let me create one more product called another memory product called 32 GB. I will just quickly go and create one more product and would like to add this product in the under this bundle. Very quick, just click on clone button. What it does, Salesforce CPQ, Salesforce has created this product. Let me quickly edit. Memory card of 32 GB. Okay, make it 32 GB. Save. Okay, and this pricing, let me change the pricing very quickly. So $10 a product. So after creating this product, what I have to do, I'll have to add into the particular bundle that I have created. So I have created this bundle called Canon 20M megapixel camera. Go to these options. Click on new. Or what you can do, you'll have to select this memory and click on clone button. Just click on clone. Okay, this is not required, not selected. It's got 30. I have my another SKU called 32 GB, and click on save. Okay, so what I did, I have added another memory card under this bundle. So let me navigate to my, let me cancel this bundle one more time. Let me configure it for you again. Canon. Click on select. So now you can see I have two options. One is called, either I can select this one or either I can select this one, right? I cannot select both. I can select either this product or this product. So I'm picking any one of these two and click on save. So this is the configurator screen where you can pick and choose based on your based on the company requirement. Now too few options are selected in the main product. Okay, I did one wrong thing here. Let me go back to my Canon digital camera. I don't need this feature for main product because my main product is already a bundle product, so I don't need this one. Let me delete. Okay, what it does, Salesforce CPQ has landed up onto this line editor page. You can add the discount if you would like to give the discounting and click on calculate button. After discounting, this much price will be derived, then click on save button. What it does, these are all quote line item get created. Under the quote line item, you can see these are all four quote line item. You have main camera cases and these are all prices are available, right? And then you can also go and generate the document. Let me see what next I have in my bucket. My next slide, I talked about like how to create this bundle. I'm going to discuss about the option constraint. The option constraint are basically another feature in your bundle, and with help of this option constraint, you can define, you can make the dependency on these two product or multiple product group, or as well as you can provide the exclusion also. So dependency meaning that you can create the inclusion is required. Dependency meaning that if you have chosen a product A, you can only select the product B if the product A is being selected. This is called what called dependency. Exclusion meaning that if you have already selected product A, you cannot choose the product B. This is what called exclusion. So in the options constraint, it is very much easy to define this option constraint, exclusion and inclusion. These are all demo example. You can see if I have already selected my 1 year warranty, I cannot select the 3 year warranty for my bundle. So this is what called exclusion. Dependency meaning that if I can choose only a cabinet, I can only select the CPU fan until unless this cabinet is being selected. So means, if I have selected the cabinet, then only I would be able to select my fan. Okay, so these are all exclusion and dependency comes under the a definition name called option constraint. So let me go and quickly give you the meaning of this some constraint. Okay, so in this bundle, you can see I have two option constraint. One is called exclusion. Another one is called dependency. These are all product options. The 72 and 73 are basically my individual product item. The exclusion is for if I choose one of the product, I cannot select the another product. And dependency meaning that I can only select the product A if the product B is selected. So it is very easy to define that as option constraint for the bundle. Within the bundle, what you have to do, you'll have to click on a new option constraint, put your constraint name, and choose your constraint options and constraining option. So let's suppose product B can only be selected dependency. If you like to create a dependency, means product B can only be selected if your product A is selected. It's what called dependency. Okay. So what I have to just create this record in the option constraint. Let me go back to my code, and I would like to show you how this dependency and exclusion are working. Let me click on edit line very quickly. I think we are short by time, and the Salesforce CPQ has like very lengthy program that you can say, a very lengthy item in order to each configure and each and everything, because I wanted to like give you the demo rather than passing to the slides actually. So stay for some more like half an hour, 30 minutes, we'll be closing very soon. Thank you. So I am selecting this Logitech computer bundle. I have created this bundle. I would like to give you just a demo for our product. Okay. Now you see this particular like warranty. If you see, if I'm selecting the standard warranty, I cannot select the 3-year warranty because I have already selected the standard warranty, right? So this particular piece I have achieved through with help of option constraint called exclusion. Another one is called, I can only select this CPU fan if I select the Logitech cabinet actually. So I cannot select this individual actually. I cannot go and select the CPU fan until unless the CPU cabinet is get added. So this is what called dependency. So there is an option constraint of two type called dependency and exclusion. I'm moving to my next slide deck, where I will discuss about the pricing method. What all pricing method are being provided by the Salesforce CPQ? The Salesforce CPQ provides the list price, cost price, block price, percent of total. Let me go back and individually. The list price is basically your MRP price. As you see, I have defined the list price in my standard price book. Whatever the price book you have defined, that will come under your product price book engine. I'm not going to cover anything about this demo. Let me move back to our cost price. What is actually the cost price? Why do we need cost price to be there? Right? The cost price are basically used for all manufacturing product, where let's suppose you have some distribution model, right? You have a different margin for different distributorship, right? So one of your partner is selling your large item, right? In that scenario, for your distributor who is very, very much captured your all of the market, the markup is very less for them. Some of the markup will be very high in nature for those distributor who is not dealing with me for a frequent orders. So my markup price will be less than the one distributor partner to the another distributor partner. So what Salesforce CPQ provides, another pricing method called cost price. Okay. And in that scenario, let me give you the one of the example that I took called apple vinegar of 1 liter, which is the cost of ₹2. And while selling to the 100 liter of bottle, I would like to add some markup price on top of that. Okay. What I did, let me navigate to the very quickly for the product that I have created. I have created called apple vinegar of 1 liter. And in this scenario, if you see the pricing method, I have a different pricing method. One is called list price, cost, and percent of total, as well as the third one is called block price. So what I have done, I have chosen a pricing method called cost. Okay. After defining the pricing method, there is just a related item called cost section. In this section, you can go and publish your price accordingly. So for every product, of this apple vinegar of 1 liter, I'm going to charge you only $1. Okay. So for, let's suppose, in order to produce this apple vinegar, I require a raw material, right? In that raw material, what it happened, the raw material gets changed over the time. So my pricing or my land up cost will be changed accordingly, right? So what I will do, I will start defining a new cost for every month or every quarter or every yearly, right? I can go and change my cost accordingly, right? So I have defined my price cost called $2.50 for 1 liter of a product. Let me go back quickly and add this product onto my quote. I have apple vinegar of 1 liter product. I have selected this product. I can see the $2, which is my net unit price, is 2.50, which is my cost price. My cost price is this much, but I would like to take the markup of 10% extra for one of the distributor company, right? So my net unit price will become a 2.75. So I'm going to sell a 100 liter quantity to my partnership, right? So this way you can add the markup on top of your cost price, okay? So this is the beauty of how you can define another pricing method called cost and how you can use it. Now coming to the block price, I talked about, like, we have list price, cost price, then block price. Block price are basically, let's suppose you are having your Salesforce editions, right? You have a different license type. If company or customer is buying 110 license, I will give you the this much of cost. If the customer is buying like more than 110 license, I will charge this off this monthly, this much of per license per user per month cost, right? So based on this monthly subscription, I have created one Netflix monthly subscription program where I have put in my base quantity, which is basically, if you see the block price, my 1 to 4 quantity, my price is $5. Means what it happened, if you are defining your block price, your upper bound is not included in the CPU calculation. It will calculate 1 to 3 and then 4 to 10, and after 10 it will apply the pricing accordingly. Let me go back to the Netflix monthly product that I have set up in my system. So what you have to do, you'll have to just go and create this product with the product name and product code. You'll have to choose the price method called block, and the subscription term is called 1 month, because my Netflix subscription is my monthly subscription. If you are selling the annually subscription, so put it 12. Here the subscription term is basically your month, number of months. Now after defining this block, what you have to do, you'll have to go a section related item called block price. In this, you will see the button name called edit all. What you have to do, you will have to define this tier pricing in the Salesforce CPU for the particular product. So from, I have to give the price name, the lower bound, and then upper bound, then price. So what I'm trying to do, for quantity 1 to 3, I'm charging you the $5. From quantity 4 to 10, I'm going to charge you $10. My above, beyond that, 11, I will charge you $12 each, okay? So now if you go back and start adding this product called Netflix subscription, click on save, select, it will navigate to this. This much is pricing is coming just because of, I have for one quantity, I'm charging you the $5. If I'm choosing for called 6, my price will get changed. Okay. This is for like a 1 month subscription. If I change for annual subscription, let's suppose, if I'm putting the subscription term called 12, my pricing will be changed, because now I'm selecting the 6 quantity, which is $10 per unit actually. Okay. So this is how the pricing will be applicable for your block pricing. Now I'm moving to the another pricing method called percent of total. So if you see this screen, in this screen or in this image, my block, my Dell Inspiron installation fees is totally depend on my hardware or main machine called desktop. This is the two product. I have one Dell new Inspiron desktop model, which is $1,500, but in order to install, I will charge you the $10, 10% of this much of price actually. So this is what called percent of total. Means if your product is totally depend on your percent of quote total, if this particular product price is may depend on your hardware component price, may depend on some other quote line item price actually. So that is why it is called percent of total pricing. Let me navigate to the Salesforce CPQ, how I have configured for Dell and Inspiron product price. Let me go back here. Dell. What I did, I have created two product. One is called Dell Inspiron 27790 model. Another one is called the installation fees. Okay. So I have two product. One is called installation fees. Another one is called my main machine. My main machine price is basically a cost of $1,500. If you go back to my installation fees, this installation fees is a pricing method called percent of total. The pricing method is a percent of total of what? A 10% of my total lease price for this particular product actually. Okay, so whenever any person or any sales rep is going to quote, what it does, Salesforce CPQ will automatically apply this pricing for this particular product name called installation fees. If my installation fees is a 5% of that product, so accordingly my price strategy will be changed. My price will be changed. Let me navigate to my quote screen. I'm going to add a product name called Dell. You see, if I'm going to change the two quantity, what it does, my price will be changed, my installation will be changed. Right? I'm charging you like $300, right? So this way you can see I have a four different price method in my quote CPQ. Now I'm navigating to the last item called quote template PDF document. In order to create a quote template PDF document, what you have to do, you'll have to follow these steps. One is to define the quote template. Another one is to define the template content. And then you'll have to create the quote term if you would like to use the quote term also. Okay, let me quickly go and navigate to one of the quote document that I would like to generate. Let me save this document. Let me save this quote first. I would like to generate a document. Then I will showcase you how you can create the quote template document in the system. There is a two option called preview document or generate document. If I go and click on a generate document, I can see the template that I have selected here called CPQ template. Here you see the send Adobe Shine also. So these are all plugins that I have added in my system. If I go and click on a preview options, what it does, Salesforce CPQ will automatically generate a quote PDF document that sales rep can generate and send to the customer. I can see my customer logo. I can see my company header. I can see some of the CPQ, my quote related information, my quote number, which is going to be expired, one on which date it is going to be expired, from whom it is being generated, right? And what all item I'm going to sell, right? I have my Dell Inspiron product, this much of features, blah, blah, blah features. I'm charging that installation fees also for this much, right? And then you have your term and condition, what all term condition are being signed, right? So in your quote template, you can see you have four pages, right? You can see your main header, under header you have your quote detail, then you have your quote line item detail, then you have your term and condition, and the fourth and last is basically your signature section. So this piece has a fourth section in the code template section. Okay. So let me navigate to the tab. What it Salesforce CPQ will provide, it provides code template. There are three main tabs are required. One is called code template. Another one is called code term. And third one is called template content. So please be remember, you need code template, you need code term if you are using code term, not necessarily, but you need a template content. So these are all three tabs are basically required in order to configure your code template. Okay, what it does, you'll have to create a new code template. In this code template record, you'll have to define your page width, you'll have to define your header, you'll have to define your corporate name, your company name, the company name, the company phone number. You'll have to just provide this information and click on save with the standard settings. Okay. Now, after defining this code template record, you'll have your two related more item called line item, line columns. Another one is called sections. Line column will tell you what all line, what all the columns that you like to showcase on your generated PDF document. So let's suppose I would like to show, I do not want to show the product code. I would like to show the product name as well as the product code, as well as the description, unit price. I do not want to show the discount percentage. What I will do, I will go to my code template, and in this section, I will go to my line column. I will delete these columns, whatever it is not required. If you would like to show some custom field, which is your definition, which is defined by you for your company, you can add those columns in this sections. Okay. Now, after creating this code template and adding this line item, what you have to do, you'll have to add these sections actually. So these sections, before you start with these sections, you'll have to define the template content. Okay. My template top content is my section name. In this particular template section name, I have a template content. In this template content is basically your, let me open this template content. This template content is basically our HTML content. In this template content, I have my company logo, I have my company name, I have my company slogan, I have my company street addresses. These are all merge field that you can use, and these merge field definition you can just go and pick up from the Salesforce standard article. You can read primary contact.name. I have code.shipping name. I have my code shipping addresses. I have my salesperson name. These are all default field are available under the Salesforce CPQ program. So this one is our template content, comes under your template content tab. You can go and edit this value if you do not want to change, if you wanted to change anything here, right? After defining this template content, you'll have to create this section and give the ordering sequences actually. So what I did, I have created a code template, created this template content, and this template content added into my section called template content sections. Okay, now this is the standard line item template content. Let me show you the template content, what all template content provides, what all type are there in the template content. You have five type of template content. You have HTML, you have line items, you have code terms, you have custom, you have template bottoms and template top. So the template bottom and tops are basically, the Salesforce CPQ provides a by default a signature automatically. You can just go and change this template according to your need and then add to your template sections under this code template section. So if you go and open this template content, signatures block, which is your last display order is my 70, right? You open this signature box block, Salesforce CPQ signature block. This is the Salesforce CPQ. This is the HTML block that I have created. You can go, if you are much more familiar with the HTML, you can go and edit to the HTML, design your page accordingly and click on save. After defining this template content, you'll have to go and add the value in in the code template PDF document. So this way you can generate and define this code template and publish for your default purpose, and then this can be used by your end user to generate this code PDF document. So I think probably due to lack of time, I cannot cover more onto that part, but definitely will go with more down the line. I will sync up with my team. They will present some more interesting part for you. I think probably I'm done. Yeah, I'm done with.
We'll have more sessions in future, so we can cover up the things which we have missed out, and we can have more demos in future in like maybe upcoming meetups on CPQ more. So if anyone has any question, please feel free to ask.
Yeah, go ahead. Sorry, I was not monitoring this. Okay, why two product family fields? Okay, so sorry about that part. This is like my trial org. So I have created mistakenly this product family field. Bharat, answer to you. Arun Singh, quite extensive and detailed. Thank you. No problem. Thanks for your feedback.
Hi, Amul.
Thanks for your feedback, Sunil.
Am I audible?
Yeah, audible. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. You can carry on. You can respond over that chat. It's okay. I'll ask later on.
No problem. Let me read very quickly for you all. Can we install CPQ on the org? We need a special. No. You can install this Salesforce CPQ org for enterprise, basically, where you have at least Salesforce CPQ package can only be installed if you have enabled your order as well as the assets. So keep in mind, if you are using the enterprise org or any sales org where your sales cloud is being configured, on top of that, the Salesforce CPQ can be installed. Okay, either it is your enterprise or professional edition or your unlimited, or you can install, go and install. But before you install, you might face some challenges. Let's suppose your order is not enabled. You will have to go and install, enable the order. Let's suppose you are using the assets. Salesforce CPQ uses the assets actually. If the assets is not enabled in your org, you will have to go and enable the assets and order first in the system. I think I just answered to Arun Sood. You need to an any event in your DevOps. You can do in any event in your DevOps. Okay. I think now Parth. Okay. Trial 90. Yes. So if you are installing a Salesforce CPQ, what it does is a 90 days availability period. So you cannot go and use beyond 90 days actually. So you'll have to keep in mind if you are playing with any kind of like exercise on the Salesforce CPQ stuff. You'll have to keep in mind you have only 90 days period of time to expire. Okay, what else I have? Let me quickly read. Thanks, Sunil.
Yeah, we just have last question in the chat.
Yeah, please. Let me read.
Yeah.
Okay. It was helpful. Thanks, Chetan. Thanks, KK. Do we need to assign a CPQ page layout for all CPQ objects, or do you need many objects like account opportunity? Okay, let me tell you, the Salesforce CPQ page layout is not necessary. The standard one, which is provided by the AppExchange packages, but for the product, because this product definition are totally related to the CPQ admin part, please, the moment this CPQ package is being installed, you guys can go and assign this standard layout for admin, so that admin user will have the access to all objects and related item and sections and related sections for our product layout. Definitely for account and opportunity, if you are using contracting and renewal and amendment, the account has those objects and related objects and field that are being necessarily required to configure those fields and related object on accounts, configure those fields and related object on opportunities. Definitely the contract is also a standard one. So you'll have to also configure your contract layout accordingly. So not only the account, opportunities and contract, you'll have to also update your product as well as the apart from that, there is no other object that you have to configure for the CPU layout. I just answered to Kunal Kaushik. Okay, when should we one go ahead with the Salesforce CPU instead of the standard Salesforce functionality for opportunity and for? When should one go with the Salesforce CPU instead of the standard? Okay, so let's suppose why to use the Salesforce CPU. The Salesforce CPU is a complex pricing model. Let's suppose one of your customer is using Excel sheet in order to maintain their product, in order to sell to the quote to the customers, right? The Salesforce CPU is a wide variety tool that supports your bundle, that supports your different pricing strategy. That Salesforce CPU also provides your renewal model, the contracting model, right? So whenever any expiry comes in, you can go and start renew those contract within the system. So Salesforce CPU provide a wide variety of features like amendment, renewals, subscriptions, asset expirations, as well as the nice and fancy quote a document PDF, as well as the DocuSign and Adobe Sign that you can plug. This is the answer to Mr. Ganesh. Okay. What is the difference between the Salesforce CPQ opportunity standard product functionality and the CPQ? Okay. There is no difference between the standard CPQ product functionality and the CPQ product functionality. CPQ product are common for both, for standard and Salesforce CPQ. So Salesforce CPQ is using the standard port product object. Answer to Chris. Okay, is there any contract connector we can use the CPQ port in B2B commerce? Yes. Okay, so in order to B2B commerce, Salesforce CPQ comes with another plugin connector that you can check on a portal. Right now I am not in memorizing those things. You can go and check. Definitely it is available, and you can just make the connection between your B2B commerce as well as your Salesforce CPQ. Thank you, Vamsi. Any other questions? I cannot see any other questions. Please go ahead.
Yeah, guys. I think we are done with all the questions.
Yep. Thanks. So, thanks everyone. Really appreciated your effort and time. Thanks, Partho.
Thanks a lot. It was a really useful session, and hopefully we'll have more CPQ sessions from you in future. I know like we have missed on time today, but definitely we'll have more sessions.
I think probably this Salesforce CPQ, if you talk about like a session to be provided by me, actually, I generally used to believe on the demos actually. Until and unless these demos are not happening, I'm not navigating with the Salesforce CPQ. The feeling has to happen only once the moment you start playing within the system, right?
100%. We'll make sure that next time whenever we are in the session, we have a play on org with us.
Yeah.
We can have it together, or maybe we can do the little customization together and learn more about it.
Right. So one more request, I think probably if you stretch this time for not 45 minutes, just stay for one hour and 10 minutes, it would be sufficient enough to provide you the good session. Otherwise, what it happened if you have navigated.
No issues about it. Next time we'll have more time, and we'll communicate with the people so they all can be present and attend it.
Thanks, Partha, and okay, thanks everyone for joining the session.
Thanks, everyone. Thanks, Amul. At the end, I just wanted to ask a quick question. Sorry, Parth.
No,
so, Amul, Parth, Vipul, me, Monica, anyone can approach you in future for the further session. So, we are basically conducting all these sessions for Chandigarh community. So, at the end, I just wanted to know, is your Twitter account is private? Because I'm trying to search you. I'm not able to see you there.
Can you please check Monica, you can check our tweets also, because we have tagged him, and I'll communicate you with the LinkedIn profile of Amul, so you can have a communication over there.
Yeah, I clicked on that, somehow it's not showing for me. Oh, anyways, I'll check one more time. It's okay. All right, thank you everyone. Thanks
Monica, thanks everyone.
Thanks, Pastor. Have a good day.
Thanks, guys.